Hello everyone, my name is Ravi Angwar and today I will be teaching velocity diagram. Before proceeding this topic, let us understand what we have discussed in previous lecture. In previous lecture, I have discussed about the steam turbine. So basically, your steam turbine consists of a nozzle and a ring of moving blades that are mounted on a shaft. And the shaft motion will depend upon the dynamic action of steam. A high velocity of steam enters the moving blade, due to which there will be a change in direction from inlet to outlet, which results in change in momentum. This change in momentum will cause a driving force, and this driving force will result in driving thrust. If the driving thrust will be created, definitely your motor turbine shaft will get rotated. If the turbine shaft will get rotated, you can connect this turbine shaft to any of the machinery, it can get driven. So this was a basic principle behind a steam turbine. If you want to understand the working applications and your applications advantages of the steam turbine, you can go and watch my previous video and you can understand in a great detail. Now let us come to the today's topic, that is the velocity diagram of impulse turbine. So basically, what do you understand by velocity diagram of impulse turbine? So this basically, your velocity diagram gives a brief idea of velocity of fluid entering and leaving the moving blade. Let us understand the inlet and outlet velocity triangle of impulse turbine with the help of a diagram. Now I am drawing the cross section of a moving blade. This is a cross section of a moving blade, and this blade is moving with this blade speed of u. Now I am drawing the inlet velocity diagram here, and I will draw the outlet velocity diagram here. Now see, if the blade is moving with the linear speed u, not u, you can consider it as cb, that is represented by cb. Now the steam will enter into the moving blade at an angle alpha 1, and the velocity will be c1. Steam enters the moving blade at an angle alpha 1 with the absolute velocity c1. Now what happens, the moving blade is having a linear velocity. Due to this linear velocity, there will be a relative velocity, and that will be represented by r1 at an angle beta 1. And the velocity of flow at inlet will be represented by vf1. This will be your Vf1. Now wall velocity at inlet of the moving blade will be represented by Cw1. We have drawn the inlet velocity triangle of your impulse turbine. Now we will draw the outlet velocity triangle of your moving blade. Now see, as soon when the steam will pass over the moving blade, it will leave the moving blade with the relative velocity at as v2 at an angle of beta 2, and it also leaves the moving blade at an absolute velocity c2 at an angle alpha 2. This will be absolute velocity of steam at exit of moving blade. This will be your velocity of flow at exit. This will be your blade speed, and this portion will be the velocity of whirl at outlet of moving blade. This is the inlet and outlet velocity triangle of your impulse turbine. Now I hope I must have cleared the nomenclature which I have used in this inlet and outlet velocity triangle very well. Now I will explain a combination of inlet and outlet velocity triangle. Now assume that the blade is moving with a linear speed, and that will be represented by Cv. Steam enters the moving blade at an angle alpha 1 with the absolute velocity of steam C1. This is the velocity of steam coming from the nozzle, and will be represented by C1. The moving blade is having a linear velocity, now due to which the relative velocity will be created, and will be represented by R1. And an inlet angle of moving blade will be represented by beta 1. steam will leave the moving blade at an angle beta 2 with the relative velocity of steam, that will be represented by R2. This is your R2 velocity. Now steam will leave the moving blade at an absolute velocity of steam at an angle alpha 2, that will be represented by C2. This is your alpha 2 angle and this is your C2. Now the velocity of float at inlet, velocity of flow at inlet of moving blade will be represented by VF1. This is the velocity of flow at inlet of the moving blade. Similarly, here velocity of flow at inlet to at outlet to moving blade will be represented by VF2. Now the velocity of whirl at inlet of moving blade will be represented by C omega 1. That will be represented here, C omega 1. Now C omega 2 will be the whirl velocity at outlet of moving blade. I hope I must have clear all the nomenclature used in combination of inlet and outlet velocity triangle. This is a combination. And this diagram is very important because when you solve the numericals of steam turbine, this combination of inlet and outlet velocity triangle is used, and it's very important to learn this diagram. Now, there is one concept why your R2 is less than R1. See, when the steam is passing over the blades, the friction is there, the friction will be created, and when the friction will be created, there will be a reduction in velocity. This reduction in velocity will be quantified by a parameter known as blade velocity coefficient, and it is being represented by K. So K will be, K is the ratio of R2 by R1, where K is blade, velocity coefficient. That is why your R2 is less than R1. Now in this combination of inlet and outlet triangles, steam is having two components. One is your tangential component, another is your axial component of velocity. Now how these components of velocity is being created, I will explain in detail. See what happens. Your steam is entering into the moving blades at an angle alpha 1. This is alpha 1. This is a blade speed, CB. And this is your C1. Now the component, the horizontal component will be C1 cos alpha 1. And your vertical component will be your C1 sin alpha 1. This will be alpha 1, this will be C1. Now C1 cos alpha 1 will be your tangential component of velocity, and C1 sin alpha 1 will be your axial component of velocity. This C1 cos alpha 1 is parallel to the direction of rotation of the blades. See, this is the direction of the blades. So similarly, C1 cos alpha 1, that is your tangential component of velocity, is parallel to the direction of the blades. And C1 sin alpha 1 is the axial component of velocity, and that is perpendicular to the direction of the blades. So these two components are very important because this tangential component of velocity is responsible for generation of thrust due to change in momentum. Similarly, your axial component of velocity, your flow velocity change, is responsible for creation axial thrust. So this is how your this tangential component and your axial component is very important in your combination of inlet and velocity triangles. I hope I must have cleared all the nomenclature that I have used in your velocity diagram of an impulse turbine, and this is a combination of inlet and outlet velocity triangle. See, your alpha 1 is your nozzle angle, and this beta 1 is your inlet angle of moving blades that I have written here. Beta 2 is your outlet angle of moving blade. C1 is the absolute velocity of steam at inlet of moving blades. Alpha 1 is the nozzle angle. R2 is your relative velocity of steam at outlet of moving blades. C2 is the absolute velocity of steam at outlet of moving blades. VF is the velocity of flow at outlet of moving blades, at inlet of moving blades. VF2 is the flow velocity velocity of flow at outlet of moving blades. Similarly, this alpha 2 is the nozzle angle for the second stage. So this is how the velocity diagram of an impulse turbine I have explained in a better way. I hope I must have cleared all the doubts regarding this velocity diagram of impulse turbine.